Large sandbags meant to prevent beach erosion on Plum Island are now floating away. Homeowners are upset that these so-called super sacks are ripping apart and littering what's typically a beautiful beach.
WBZ's Mike LaCrosse is in Newburyport, where the city says it can't just dig them up.
This is what they are. This is what they do. They're just falling apart.
Plum Island homeowners are upset large sandbags are now buried and breaking apart on the beach.
And I have videos of the bags floating into the ocean.
Where will these remnants end up?
The bags are called super sacks. Video from Sky Eye shows them being installed near Reservation Terrace last fall. More sacks were placed on the beach again ahead of some winter storms to prevent erosion.
At the moment, it looks like a dump.
Lila Wright has to look at the sacks every day. She says it took her husband more than an hour to try to dig one out.
We can't lift these bags.
Here's a look at what the super sacks look like when they're not buried. The mayor tells me they weigh over a ton and that the city is waiting for a permit from the state before they can begin removing them from the beach. She also tells me that it's part of a larger project.
We were really trying to find a way that we could do something to protect this area before the dredge happened. And, you know, we thought these super sacks would work.
Wood pilings and biodegradable cores will replace the super sacks to keep the beach in place until the Merrimack River dredge project later this year.
We've lost over 300 feet of beach.
Mark Sarkady of the Plum Island Foundation says a long-term solution to the rapid erosion will require the federal government to step in and make adjustments in connection to their jetties.
Once this is done, there will be security and sustainability for the residents,
allowing residents like Wright to enjoy their homes without worry.
We had a fair amount of space before the beach.
In Newburyport, Mike LaCrosse, WBZ News.